I would want to know about you and what would you suggest to a person who is just starting off on their journey with English?
From scratch, from the
Yes.
beginning.
Yes.
Okay. Ooh, okay. Well, I'm going to suggest what happened to me. So I don't know any Hindi, but yes, you can teach me some.
What do you want to say in Hindi? I will tell you, and then you can repeat after me.
That is too expensive because when I was in India, everyone tried to sell me stuff that was too expensive, which I knew.
यहाँ सब कुछ महंगा है.
Okay, let's break that down. Yaha.
यहाँ सब कुछ
यहाँ सब कुछ
महंगा है. इट्स
महंगा है,
नॉट मनी, इट्स पानी. प प फॉर पंजाब.
बट
पंजाब
आ
प.
पानी 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 पानी.
Do you want me to teach you Hindi for girlfriend?
श्योर.
महिला, महिला,
महिला महिला
मित्र, नो, मित्र, मित्र.
मित्र मित्र. तो महिला मित्र.
Hi, I just had a conversation with a tutor on Cambly. Cambly is a platform that helps you connect with English tutors from across the globe, and these are people who are native speakers of this language. So there's obviously a lot to learn from them. If you go to the description of this video, you will find a link. There's also a code that I've pasted right there. If you use that code, you can get yourself a 25% discount on any 3-month plan. So let's hop into the conversation now.
My name is Bjorn. I'm from Cape Town, South Africa. What's your name? Where are you from?
Hi, my name is Lina Reis and I'm from India.
Awesome. It's nice to meet you.
Same here, same here.
Tell me a little bit about yourself. Why are you trying to improve your English? What is your goal?
I do want to be good in English. Apart from that, I have a YouTube channel where I
Cool.
help my friends and people who've subscribed to me. I help them with English. So I'm recording a conversation because I feel that they'll be very much interested in listening to this. They are people, they really want to learn English, and it is definitely going to help. I mean, people really are hungry to learn this language in our country. So if you can,
Absolutely.
so I would want to know about you and what would you suggest to a person who is just starting off on their journey with English?
From scratch, from the
Yes.
beginning.
Yes.
Okay. Ooh, okay. Well, I'm going to suggest what happened to me. So I was born in Germany and moved to South Africa when I was 10 years old. So I knew no English
Okay.
whatsoever.
All right.
And my parents just put me into the deep end of the pool and were like, here's the South African school system, learn English. So the biggest thing is to immerse yourself in the language. Put stickers everywhere, mug, cup, cell phone, whatever, that you're surrounded by it all the time. Watch English movies, listen to podcasts, read in English as much as you can. Mickey Mouse stuff. I started reading Mickey Mouse stuff. I'm now learning Spanish and I'm reading Mickey Mouse stuff in Spanish because I know it works. And I'm like, Mickey Mouse did this. I'm like, yee. But it seems simple, but it's also like you're like, yes, I understand what's going on. I understand that Mickey just drank a cup of water, you know? So it's like small things of achievement. And practice as much as you can. I know specifically in India, it's weird. It's a catch 22. Everybody speaks English to a certain extent.
Yes.
But depending where you're from, obviously in India, it's like Punjabi, Hindi, or whatnot, Ladakh, Ladakhi, you tend to automatically go to your mother tongue. You revert back to that. So force
Yes.
yourself to speak English with your colleagues or your friend or the person at Subway or whatever. And yeah, that's pretty much my advice.
I mean, while I'm talking to you right now, I don't feel like you've learned English after a while. It feels like you've been speaking since your childhood.
Yeah, more I have since I was 10 years old.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. So that does help. The younger you learn at that, the easier it is, for sure. Absolutely. Yeah.
So
But
do you want me, I would want you to speak in Hindi for me, a sentence or two.
I don't know any Hindi, but yes, you can teach me some.
Can I teach you some?
Absolutely. Go for it. Yes. Throw some Hindi my way.
What do you want to say in Hindi? I will tell you, and then you can repeat after me. We can do it that way.
That is too expensive because when I was in India, everyone tried to sell me stuff that was too expensive, which I knew.
Okay, तो यू कैन से यहाँ सब कुछ महंगा है, यहाँ
Okay, let's break that down. यहाँ
सब कुछ
यहाँ सब कुछ
महंगा है,
महंगा है.
सो एवरीथिंग इज कॉस्टली हियर, दैट इज व्हाट आई जस्ट
ओके
फॉर
ओके
यू.
गुड गुड ओके.
महंगा इज कॉस्टली, महंगा इज कॉस्टली,
महंगा महंगा इज कॉस्टली. या
एंड
सो एक्सपेंसिव.
सब कुछ इज एवरीथिंग, एवरीथिंग.
ओके सी लाइक एवरीथिंग इज एक्सपेंसिव. व्हाई इज एवरीथिंग एक्सपेंसिव. ओके नो फेयर इनफ. या बिकॉज़ आई वाज I don't know if I was learning Hindi or Ladakhi, but bunny is water.
पानी
Bunny, right? Water. Yeah. Because I was like bunny, and I was always expecting like a rabbit. Like,
it's not बनी, it's पानी. प फॉर पंजाब, पंजाब प.
पानी. For Portugal. Okay.
यस
Pani.
यस
Okay. Yeah. But that makes sense because I was like, but because I worked in India for 3 months in the
So you go,
Himalayas.
I'll also teach you Hindi for girlfriend. Do you want me to teach you Hindi for girlfriend?
Sure.
Mahila Mitra.
Why do you gotta make it so long? Mahila Mektram. Mahila?
is funny.
Am I butchering it?
I'll help you.
Yes.
Mahila, Mahila.
Mahila. Mahila.
Mitra, Mitra is friend. Mahila is woman. So girlfriend is Mitra.
Woman friend. Okay. Mekram? What is it?
Mitra, Mitra.
Mitram.
No, Mitra, Mitra.
Mitre. Mitre.
Yeah,
Mahila
Mahila.
Mitram.
Yeah, so next time you're meeting your girlfriend, you can just let her know that you are my Mahila Mitra.
Yo, Mahila
She's right there.
Mitram. She's in the other room, but yes, Mahila Mitra. Okay, good, fantastic, awesome. So, how's your YouTube channel going? Are you just basically forcing people to like
No,
watch
no.
up?
600K already. 600K, more than that. Yeah.
Nice.
Yes. And if it keeps growing at the rate it is growing right now, probably a million in the next 4 or 5 months. So,
Oh,
yeah.
wow. It's going really well. Fantastic. Awesome. What's the name of your YouTube channel?
I'll write it down for you.
Yes, please. Or just send me the link or whatever.
I am right. So, I am the only one with this name on this on YouTube. So, you'll easily
Okay.
find. But
Fair
if I
enough.
put the entire name, it is Alina Ali's Life. That's what I call my.
Okay, fantastic. But the first thing that comes up in Google is your Instagram, and after that, like a bunch of YouTube videos. Well
Yeah,
done. So good for you. When did you start this whole adventure of to be a YouTuber?
2.5 years ago. Two and a
Nice.
half. Yeah.
Was it because I'm on YouTube too, not that much, I'm more on Instagram because I'm a photographer. Was it an uphill battle, the
It
beginning of
was,
YouTube?
it always is. It always is. It
Yeah.
was. But then after a while, I guess YouTube just recognizes that you're putting in a lot of effort and they need to help you. And then
That's true.
start pushing your content.
Yes.
So every time you reject their recommendation, they come back with another one. And that is how
That's
you.
okay. You just keep persevering. And did you just bombard YouTube with videos? Do you have a lot of content?
When nobody was watching, I think I had already shot 200 videos. And after,
Oh,
yeah, so after people started watching, I've made another 150 videos.
Nice. Well done.
So I'm a hardworking person. I've really worked my
Clearly.
way up.
Yeah.
Yes.
Is
And
this kind of, are you shifting towards this being your day job?
then it is already my day job. I
Okay.
that is, and I also teach. I teach law. I teach Indian law. That's the
Nice.
best.
And I assume you studied law, otherwise everybody will be learning like weird law.
So I'm a CA. Do you know what CA? I don't think you know what
Chartered
you know.
accountant.
CA is chartered accountant. That is like certified public accountant.
Yeah.
You are aware of CPA? CPA?
Yes.
So CA is just like CPA. And that is why I teach law because I have studied law. And I
that makes a lot of sense.
Yes.
Okay. Interesting. Do you do it in person? Do you do it live? Or like you create the course material, it's uploaded, it does its thing?
That's the way you're teaching me right now. That is the way okay. I teach.
Fantastic. Except like, I would imagine the law is a little bit more tricky.
Yeah, so we have stuff. We have slides. We use material, online material to teach. And we appear on a small window somewhere at the bottom of the screen. And the material appears on the screen and there's a chat box going on. So people, students are commenting. Yes, that is how we do. It's
the
interesting.
Same setup.
It is interesting. It is good. It's progressive. Okay. Nice. What else? So what else? Do you ever plan on coming to India? Do you want to visit India ever?
Well, I have been to India. I was in New Delhi. I was in the Himalayas for 3 months. I was helping shooting visual content production for a motorcycle touring company up in Shimla, Manali, Pangong.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, it was fantastic. I did. Yeah. Delhi itself was a very interesting experience because it's such a big city filled with so many people, with so many contrasting things of wealth and poverty. Cows and nice cars. Yeah, so it was very interesting to go into that. I liked it though. It was from a photographer's perspective, it's visually rich. It's great.
You're a photographer as well?
Yeah, I'm a photographer. Yeah, so that's my primary job as photographer. But due to the pandemic, that has all kind of collapsed. Like there aren't that many weddings, aren't that many shoots. Yeah, exactly. No one can be.
Okay, and what does your girlfriend do?
She's a yoga instructor.
Oh, she has a deep connection with India in that case.
Yeah, exactly. She has a connection right there. I mean, she speaks more Sanskrit than I do. So she like...
She knows Sanskrit. I don't know Sanskrit.
Really? Yeah. Well, I guess all the yoga poses are in like Sanskrit. And I'm like, yes.
The names are in Sanskrit.
Exactly all the right.
That's right.
Exactly right, yeah. And what about you? What are you planning on doing once this pandemic is over? What are your ambitions?
I think YouTube has picked up for me. So I'm going to obviously spend a lot of time on YouTube. Apart from that, I am already an educator. I continue doing that. But of course, I have a long time vision. I want to have a place of my own in Himalayas. So
nice. Whereabouts?
I think I am going to buy a farmhouse in Himalayas. Cool.
Where? Like which region? Like the bottom half of Shimla, more in the interior towards Manali, or like in the middle of nowhere?
Close to Shimla. Yes, Himachal. That is my long-term plan, probably short-term plan.
That's really cool. Why is Shimla?
It's peaceful, it's calm, the trees are beautiful, very green, and mountains are huge. Generally, so we have majorly Uttarakhand and we have Himachal where you find mountains. So whenever you're leaving from Delhi, Himachal or Uttarakhand, these are the two favorite options for Delhiites. So I'm telling you, there is a difference between the mountains. Himachal still has bigger mountains.
And but it's also quite barren. Yeah,
it is. You may say that. So I would prefer moving to that portion of the country.
Yeah.
I mean, where it's moving. It's like having a small place of your own, a small cottage or something where you can
like
just
go. Yeah, like a holiday house.
Yes, a couple of days relaxing, staying there and working, and then coming back to your place in Delhi. That's
excellent. Yeah, absolutely. And you are in within this digital nomad realm. You have that capability. Do it. Absolutely. I would fully encourage you to pursue that.
Hopefully that happens. Okay. I would love to connect with you on my channel also in case.
Yeah. Sure.
Please comment.
Yes, no worries. Okay.
I'll... name your full name
my full name is Bjorn Creech.
Okay, are you writing that for me?
Yes.
Okay, Bjorn Creech. That's a difficult name. Let me
it
say
is.
Bjorn.
Yeah, it's a whole, well, I mean, Bjorn in itself is Danish for bear, so
okay. But why a bear? Why exactly a bear?
I don't know, that's just what the Danish came up with. And my parents like the name, so here I am. Okay, that's all the time I have for today, though, unfortunately. But
no problem.
Feel free to call me again. You know where to find me. Have an awesome weekend.
You too. Bye-bye.
Okay.